Hello students, in this video we are going to learn about birth control methods. So what is birth control? So birth control is nothing but the voluntary use of contraceptive procedures to prevent the fertilization or prevent implantation of a fertilized egg in the uterus. That is called as birth control. Okay. So for birth control, government recommended different types of contraceptive procedures. So before that, we should know what are the characters an ideal contraceptive should possess. Now, ideal contraceptive should be user friendly and it should be easily available and it should have least side effects and it should not interfere with sexual drive. So these are the characters an ideal contraceptive should possess. So next we are going to see about what are the different contraceptive methods. So here contraceptive methods are broadly divided into two groups. They are temporary contraceptive method and permanent contraceptive method. So under temporary contraceptive method, again it possesses four different types of method. They are natural method, chemical method, mechanical method and hormonal barrier methods. So these are all the temporary methods. But under permanent method, it includes surgical sterilization methods. So here there are two types of surgical sterilization method. One is tubectomy. So this method is done in female and vasectomy done in male. So first we are going to see about natural method. So how natural method prevent the conception? But the main aim of this natural method is it prevent the meeting of sperm with ovum. What are the ways to prevent the meeting of sperm with ovum? So they are periodic abstinence or rhythmic method. Next one is continuous abstinence. Then third one is coitus interruptus. Then lactational amenorrhea. The second method is barrier methods. In the case of barrier methods, the sperm and ovum are prevented from meeting, so thereby fertilization does not occur. So here there are two types of barrier method. One is chemical barrier method, second one is mechanical barrier method. So under chemical barrier method only hormonal barrier method will come. So how hormonal barrier method prevent that conception? So here the hormonal barrier method prevents the ovaries from releasing ova. So and also it thickens the cervical fluid. So because of thickening of cervical fluid, it keeps away the sperm from the ovum. So the sperm cannot swim into the female reproductive tract. So thereby it will prevent the meeting of ovum and sperm. So one of the hormonal contraceptive method is using pills. So pills are nothing but tablets. So oral contraceptive pills, these are used to prevent ovulation. Mainly these pills are used to prevent the ovulation. So how this pills are working means, so it will inhibit the secretion of FSH, that is follicle stimulating hormone, and LH, luteinizing hormone. These are the two hormones mainly needed for the formation of ovum. Okay, so these pills inhibit the secretion of FSH and LH hormones. So what does this pills are containing means, it contains synthetic progesterone and estrogen hormone. So as the blood contain more number of progesterone and estrogen, automatically the FSH and LH won't secrete. So thus it will prevent the ovulation. So one of the example for this contraceptive pill is Sahili. So actually this drug is made by Central Drug Research Institute, CDRI, in Lucknow, India. So it can actually all the contraceptive pills are steroid pills. They possess steroid. But this institute found out a pill which is non-steroidal. So that is called as Centroman. So next we are going to see about intrauterine devices. That means these are the devices which are kept inside the uterus. So what are the different forms of these devices? Are they available as in the form of copper releasing intrauterine devices. That means these some of the devices will release the copper, and hormone releasing IUDs. That means this intrauterine device release hormones, and non-medicated intrauterine devices. So these are the three different types of intrauterine devices. So what is the use of this intrauterine device? How it is working means this intrauterine device increases phagocytosis of sperm within the uterus. That means this intrauterine device will stimulate the phagocytic process, thereby kills the sperm in the uterus itself. So the sperm won't reaches the fallopian tube to fertilize the ovum. And this IUDs, that is intrauterine devices, are ideal contraceptives for females, those who want to delay the pregnancy. And the success rate is about 95% to 99%. So it is more successful when compared to other type of contraceptive methods. So next, so one of the intrauterine devices are copper releasing intrauterine devices. So actually, there are different types of copper releasing intrauterine devices. So they will release different amount of copper. So some of the copper releasing intrauterine devices are copper, that is CU. CU means copper. Copper T380A. Then Nova T. Then copper 7. Then copper T380AG. Then multi-load 375. So these are all copper releasing intrauterine devices. They releases free copper, and also it releases copper salts into the uterus. So because of this copper, free copper and copper salt, it suppresses the sperm motility in the uterus of the female. And so how many years the particular female can keep this intrauterine device means, so it may remain in the uterus for 5 to 10 years. So some can be kept inside the uterus for 5 years, and some may be kept up to 10 years. So that means after this period, 5 years or 10 years, that device must be removed. Next, hormone releasing intrauterine device. So here the two examples given are Progestasert and LNG20. These are often called as intrauterine systems. So how this copper releasing intrauterine device working means, it increases the viscosity of cervical mucus, and thus it prevents the sperm from entering the cervix. The last IUD is non-medicated IUDs. That means it do not possess any medicine, so like hormone or copper or any other things. Okay, so actually it is made up of plastic or stainless steel and Lippe's loop. It is a double-shaped plastic device. That is the non-medicated IUDs. Okay, so next we are going to see about the last one, that is permanent birth control methods. So actually, what type of people will adopt this permanent birth control method means the people who do not want to have any more children. Actually, it is a surgical sterilization methods. The surgical sterilization methods are permanent contraception method. So this method is advised for both male and female partners in order to prevent any more pregnancies. Okay, so by doing this, it will block the transport of gametes and thus prevent the conception. So that is the importance of this permanent birth control method. So first one is tubectomy. Actually, tubectomy is the surgical sterilization in women. And so what they will do in this means, a small portion of both fallopian tubes are cut and tied up. Okay, how they will do this surgery means by making small incision, by making small hole in the abdomen or small cut in the abdomen, or they will do this surgery through vagina. What is the use of this tubectomy means? It will prevent the fertilization as well as it prevent the entry of egg into the uterus, because as the fallopian tubes are cut and they tied up, they cannot move towards the uterus, and also the sperm cannot reach the egg. Thus, the fertilization is prevented, and also the entry of egg into the uterus also prevented. So next one is vasectomy. Actually, this is the permanent contraceptive method or sterilization method that is done in male. So what they will do in this method means, in this method, both vas deferens are cut and tied through a small insertion in the scrotum. So they made small cut or small hole in the scrotum, and they cut the vas deferens and they tied up. So thereby it will prevent the sperm into the urethra. Thus the sperm cannot be released out. So it cannot be discharged. So this is the permanent birth control method in male. So next we are going to see about medical termination of pregnancy. So what do you mean by medical termination of pregnancy? So actually it is a method of abortion. So actually it is carried out in voluntary or intentional termination of pregnancy in a non-surgical or non-invasive way. So while we are doing this medical termination of pregnancy, early medical termination is extremely safe. Okay, that means up to 12 weeks of the pregnancy. So it is safe for the mother. So because it generally have no impact on women's fertility. But if medical termination of pregnancy is done in second trimester, then it is more risky. Why means? Because the fetus become intimately associated with the maternal tissue. It is tightly connected with the maternal tissue. So it is very risky process if it is done in second trimester. Why the medical termination of pregnancy is carried out? Actually, Government of India legalized this medical termination of pregnancy in 1971 for mainly for medical necessity. So not only for medical necessity, but also for social consequence, with certain restriction like sex discrimination and illegal female feticides to avoid its misuse. So for that, they made this MTP as made it as legalized in 1971. Sometimes this MTP may be illegally done by unqualified quacks, that is unqualified persons, which is unsafe for that woman. Okay, it may lead to death also. And this MTP of the first conception, so if the medical termination pregnancy is carried out to the woman who is undergone first conception, that may lead to serious psychological consequences. So these are all the risk under MTP. So okay students, in this video you have learned about different contraceptive methods, how it is working, and also you have learned about permanent birth control methods and medical termination of pregnancy, and what are all the risk factor under this medical termination pregnancy. The next video we can see about sexually transmitted diseases. Thank you.